Okay, so have you ever seen one of those how it started and how's it going memes on social media? Well, I'm about to make one of those videos right now, so let's just jump into it.
Gotta talk about my life as I see it.
What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Now, if you're new here, my name is Jonathan Moore. I have a visual media company. I'm a creative entrepreneur, and I like to make videos like these for other creatives out there who are trying to build a life on their terms and get it how they live. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about how it started and how it's going so far as my business is concerned. So let's just dive right into it. Let's kick it off with how it started. Well, basically the way it started is with a dream, right? Basically, I've always wanted to own my own business. I always wanted to, you know, work for myself and, you know, live the whole American dream, quote unquote, per se, but I just never had the confidence and belief that I could do it and sustain it on a full-time basis. Well, what ended up happening was back in 2017, I quit my job and I went for it. I went headfirst into, you know, owning my own business, starting my own thing, and really moving towards the whole, you know, American dream. Now, when I first started my business, it initially started as a social media marketing agency, okay? When I was about to make the leap, when I was about to dive in, I had took a couple of courses online, and one of them was about running a social media marketing agency. And of course, this course was offered by the one and only Mr. Knowledge himself, Ty Lopez.
Here in my garage.
Now, at this time, I didn't really know much about Ty Lopez. Fast forward to today, if you were to ever ask me if I would take another course of his again, the answer would be no, but at the time, the course was very valuable. I did learn a lot of things about the art of marketing on social media. So with my newfound knowledge, I was all jazzed up and I went out there and I started to, you know, get clients. I started to build up a little list, right? I had a little book of business going on and things were going pretty good, right? I had a mixed bag. I had people I was doing social media marketing for, and I had people who I was just strictly creating content for, meaning, you know, videos and photography. Well, as everything was underway and things were going good seemingly, all of a sudden, out of the blue, basically I lost half of my clients all in one shot, boom, just like that. Now, although this setback did suck, right, because I lost half of my clients, I lost a lot of my income, all right, I kind of had to sit back and think about what it was that I was doing. Now, this is when I had my aha moment, right? I realized that I had lost half my clients and half of them I had kept. Now, the ones that I had lost, I noticed that I was doing social media marketing for. On the other hand, the clients that I kept were ones that I was doing strictly content for, video and photography, nothing else. So that told me a valuable lesson right there, which was I basically wasn't that good at social media marketing. So from there, I was able to focus and I was able to niche down and only focus on creating content, right? So now, instead of trying to be a social media marketer and, you know, creating content for these clients, basically, I just created content and started working with different social media marketers, right? Or I would work with that client and I would just make content for them and then they would give it to their social media marketing team. Now in this, I had basically found a winning formula and from there, I was able to start building up my clients again. Now in the meantime of this journey, I was doing a lot of learning, right? I had to learn how to run a business because when you do this full time, you have to do everything, right? I had to learn about, you know, just running a business in general. I had to learn about sales. I had to learn about marketing. I had to learn about networking. And these are all things that I previously didn't have to do when I was an employee, right? Because essentially when you have a job, you really just have to show up and complete the task of that job. You don't have to do any of the back end work. You don't have to, you know, do any of the HR. You don't have to do any of the bookkeeping. You don't have to do everything it takes to keep the ship afloat. But when you're in it, especially all by yourself, all of a sudden these tasks and responsibilities fall on you if you want to be responsible. So not only during this time was I out there hustling like an animal, right? And trying to figure it out as I went along, I was also learning, acquiring new skills and just trying to figure it out as I went along. Now, during this time, as I'm trying to figure it all out, I did have a bit of a discovery, right? And that discovery was essentially making videos on YouTube and or creating original content that I could either sell or license. Now, during this part of my journey, I had joined a Veda challenge, similar to what I'm doing right now. And it was vlogging every day in April. So at this point in time, I was making, you know, YouTube videos a little bit for my own channel, but I did have clients I was working with. I was helping them film and produce and actually manage their channels a little bit, right? And so I had ended up joining this beta challenge, right? I hopped on in and I started making videos every day. Now, when all this was happening, it was pretty cool to kind of see what was all going on, right? Because essentially when I joined this beta challenge, there was a community of people who were out there doing the same thing. We were all supporting one another. And it was interesting to see the different paths that everybody took. So, you know, some people just completely fell off. Some people got really involved into the whole YouTube community. And there was people like myself who was kind of in the middle, right? I didn't have a super, you know, hardcore community of fans. I wasn't completely in the whole YouTube culture and attending, you know, conferences or speaks or meeting up with people and all that other jazz. But I also didn't fall off completely 100% because during this time, a lot of the videos that I had got a few watches, mainly from the people who were participating in this, but I had a few videos that actually really took off and went viral in relative to, you know, my views, right? They went viral for me, and it really opened my eyes to what this YouTube thing could really be all about. Also during this time, I was trying to discover different ways to make passive and residual income, right? I was learning more about the differences between a service-based business and an asset-based business. And once I had learned and saw those differences, I knew that I wanted to make a transition more so over to the asset side, right? Instead of just having complete service-based business. So without getting too into the weeds, let's fast forward to current day. So current day, basically right now, I have my visual media company. I'm doing well. I'm able to support myself. I'm able to support my family, right? I'm able to, you know, make sales and make it happen. But I also want to know what I could do more so on the side of creating my own content and having my own products, right? So here's an interesting thing. While coming along, last year we had a pandemic, right? And this created a lot of obstacles in a lot of different people's businesses. Now, being that my business is mainly service-based, right? And a lot of it was in person, this made it difficult to conduct business because we had lockdowns, we had shutdowns, you weren't supposed to go nowhere, you know? And it just turned into a whole mess of everybody just scrambling to try to figure it all out. One of the biggest lessons that I took away during the whole shutdown was that, you know, having a service-based business is great, but, you know, let's face it, you can't predict when something like that happens. But it also made me realize how important having an asset-based business was as well. And so it really made me think about the stock photography that I was doing and also the videos that I was creating on YouTube. I also looked into all types of different hustles, and I've had some success and some failures, right? But as far as selling t-shirts online or selling, you know, digital presets, everything just digital or print on demand, where I don't have to hold stock or inventory, but I can continue to make sales off of one product, right? I can take one product and make a bunch of sales off of that one product. And so when the lockdowns and the pandemic was like fully underway, right? This was a huge obstacle, but it also created new opportunities, right? And during this time, this is actually when my channel for YouTube had got monetized, and it really opened up my eyes to the different possibilities and the different type of work that I could be creating and making and possibly, you know, making a couple of dollars off of. So basically I went into a whole rant, but how it started was with a dream, learning, failing, you know, trying to do the best I can, being all over the place and trying to build a life for myself. As to fast forward, how's it going? Right now, things are going good, but I'm looking to switch up the way that my business basically works, right? I want to start to make a shift because right now my business is like 80-20, right? It's 80% service and 20% product. But if I could, I like to flip that equation so I can have 80% products and maybe 20% service and then try to reclaim some of my time back. So that's where I'm at right there. I have a couple of plans on how I'm going to try to achieve this goal. Right now, everything isn't completely, you know, in place. I don't have this super strict strategic plan on how I'm going to do it, but I do know that it is possible, and I just kind of got to find the right way to achieve it. So right now I'm at a point where I have another obstacle in my way, right? And essentially the obstacle is the way. Whatever the obstacle is the way that you're going to get to achieving your goal. So that's it for me today, guys. Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. If you made it this far, hopefully I gave you guys some type of value, some type of an insight on, you know, how things kind of take time to, you know, manifest and turn into something. And also realizing that these different obstacles that we have are actually the opportunities, all right, before us to get to the goals that we are trying to achieve. So with all that being said, for all my people out there who are trying to build a life on their terms and get it how they live, this is your man, Jonathan Moore, and I'm signing out. Peace.